Deux jours, une nuit.
Two days, one night. Luc et Jean-Pierre Dardenne are here with us, along with Marion Cotillard and Fabrizio Roncione.
Je me souviens que vous me disiez.
Thank you for being here, and I remember you had told us many times that you would never work with a star, and so last time it was with Cécile de France, and this time you have an international star, Marion Cotillard, and she's wonderful. Why Marion Cotillard? Because she's such a great actress, and really, we really wanted to work with her. My brother and I found the right formula to sum up our first meeting. For us, it was a cinematographic. We were thunderstruck, or we fell in love cinematographically. Why did you want her? Because she's a great actress, and all great actresses can find the way to play the role. It was everyone's wish, but I think what make everything possible are the rehearsals we have, because the rehearsals belong to no one, not to any of one individual, because it's something we all do together. It transforms people, bodies, we discover things, and that's what happened. And Marion, first of all, the Dardenne Brothers cinema, was it something you wanted to try? Yes, I love their films. I've seen them all, or almost.
Pas le premier, mais je les ai tous aimés.
And I loved them all.
C'est au-delà du fin. J'étais même pas arrivée à m'autoriser à ce que ça me fasse envie, parce que pour moi c'était absolument impossible.
Even let myself ever dream of doing it, because I thought it would be impossible. And so when they asked me to work with them, it took me a while to realize what was happening. So how did this happen? These rehearsals, did you find it easy to adapt to their way of working? Were you surprised with their meticulous way of working? I wasn't surprised by all of this precision and how demanding they are, because when you see their films and you know something about filmmaking, you realize that to achieve these results, a lot of work is required. And what I like more than anything is to discover new worlds, new ways of working with each film. And this is what happened with Jean-Luc, I mean Jean-Pierre and Luc. So by Luc and Jean-Pierre, that's what I meant to say. And it's everything I've always dreamt of in the relationship between directors and actors, to go into such detail. So it was a dream to experience this. Fabrizio, you were practically born in front of the Dardenne brothers' camera. How have their way of working changed? Did they change when they were working with Marion? Was it always the same way of working? It's always the same demand. I wasn't practically born with them. I have two fathers. I was born through their work, and so the demand is always as stringent. There's a lot of rehearsals. We rehearse even on the day of the shoot, and as they said, all the bodies, whether those of the actors, their own, those of the technicians, work together, and since Rosetta, that has never changed.
Qu'est-ce qui change justement depuis Rosetta?
What has changed since Rosetta?
Cette histoire que vous racontez là,
this story you are telling here, this confrontation and the crisis situation with this choice, where everyone must choose between having one of their colleagues fired and receiving their bonus. Well, we have read many events in the news where we live, and similar events in the U.S. and in Italy, where in the context of a certain economic crisis, the company managers offer their employees the choice of firing certain employees and or getting a premium and a bonus. And so perhaps solidarity is more difficult now. But what our film says is how Sandra, thanks to her husband's help, will create solidarity by going to see people to convince them to vote in her favor. She herself becomes someone else. And by going out to others with her husband's support, she becomes a woman who is no longer afraid, and especially no longer afraid to express her opinion. And Marion Cotillard, we have the feeling that this is something that was in you and that you have already felt.
Je suis quelqu'un qui paradoxalement
peut. Yes, paradoxically, I am someone who may have no fears, while also being afraid not of everything perhaps, but of many things, of confronting certain things. And in her place, in her situation, I would have needed a husband, children, friends to support me.
Et son mari notamment, qui a vraiment
and the husband who has
who
loves her completely, helps her reveal the strength that she, her own inner strengths. It's not that she doesn't know where to find it, but she simply never imagined that she had this since she has come out of a depression. And it's true that her relationship with her husband
is
something wonderful in this film. So it's a good thing you're here, Fabrizio. Yes, that's what my mother says too.
Non, mais oui. Bah oui, en fait, c'est. Bah moi, je me suis inspiré
found my inspiration from people in my family. I have uncles who've been living with my aunts for 40, 50 years, and I've always seen how they respond to difficult situations where they are very present, without ever really expressing their love with words. It's through bodily expression and this strength that he provides her. So it's a form of artistic commitment. Is there also a political commitment? Is this a political statement when you work with the Dardenne brothers? That's not what I had in mind when I accepted this role. I wanted to tell this story, which is anchored in real life and talks about today's world, today's society, the society we live in.
But
I don't know if I really answered the question, but that was not what I had in mind. You went there for the story they wanted to tell. So there's nothing political about it. It's just a desire to tell a story that's important and that is really reflects today. So telling these real-life stories that seem very simple, but to make them something fascinating. Is that what the stakes are? That's what we're after. Because we talk about the people, little people with little joys, little suffering, and it's been a long time since people in the theater and in cinema show that little people have great expectations, great hopes, great suffering. These are the people we know. We feel that through their that these everyday stories are universal in their impact. And so this is a story that is built up in a year and a half, in an hour and a half. The solidarity among colleagues, something that is often missing, and this is that separates us all from each other. This is a universal message, and this is something very strong. Does it help you? Yes, it's always hard for me to talk of a message because each viewer takes what they want or what they need to take from a film, and sometimes it's quite unexpected and surprising, but it's true.
Effectivement, moi, j'entends parler Jean-Pierre.
Jean-Pierre, I think of my grandmother who couldn't stand that being described as belonging to the little people, laborers, people who worked hard. This is what characterized them, because these were not people who were considered great people by society in general, but yes, telling the story of such people through the eyes of the Dardenne brothers is something that has a great impact on us. It's very inspiring. And I always wanted to delve into real people to try to understand something somewhere. What she does in front of your camera, you were also wondering if an actress like Marion Cotillard could play in such a realistic way. We have worked with unknown actors who were very young, but when we thought of Marion, as soon as we met, because we had offered her a role for another film which we didn't make, but when we thought of this character Sandra, she was the one we thought of. And at one point we said, perhaps we should go and see Marion in Paris. This is a different role from the one we offered. Are you still interested? And she said, yes, I'm interested in the role and I would like to work with you. And we said, that's the same thing for us. And so we tried to see her whenever, because before we rehearsed with the actress, we rehearsed together. Does he play Marion well? Did you see any of that? I'd love to see that kind of a rehearsal. So you're Marion. He's Marion. So he does it on odd days, I do it on even days. And we never imagined that the cinematographic image of this film or her role as a spokesperson for the greatest brands in fashion would change anything. The rehearsals we did together enabled us to develop this character, and we all worked together. I have to say that she was really amazing. I take advantage of this situation to say so, because working with the Dardenne brothers is an investment of the body, since the body is how we express emotions, because we don't really talk much with the Dardenne brothers. We rehearse, and like everyone else, I had a certain apprehension, and when I saw Marion join us with this bodily expression, I was very impressed. Congratulations. That's all I can say to all four of you. Thank you, Marion Cotillard, Fabrizio, Jean-Luc, Jean-Pierre, Luc and Jean-Pierre. And this film will be released tomorrow, and it's in the